Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an Rx3i processor. I have here an IC695CPE310 and it's connected to an IC695CHS007 slot rack, which is otherwise empty. The test is going to be only on the processor. And it's being powered by an IC695PSA040 power supply. Okay. Now, as you can see, I've already got the power supply powered up and the unit powered up. It's gone through its self-diagnostic test and it's landed in the CPU OK mode. So the first thing I want to point out is if this is a processor that you're testing or you're following this video to test your CPE310 because you think it may be troubled, and if you don't get an OK light on, or if this is blank or blinking red, then that would mean that the processor needs repair or replacement. Okay, that's something we'll talk about in a few minutes. But if you do have an OK light on, you'll be able to follow the test. And the purpose of the test is to test the various ports that we have, and also the run mode enabled disabled button. The cable that I'm going to be using for this test is an HE693CBL232. And the connector or adapter for the 15-pin COM2 port is an HE693SNP232. Okay, when we do the COM1, we're going to use a gender adapter, which I'll show you in a moment. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is, once I've got the unit powered up and it's plugged in Prophecy Machine Edition software, we're going to open up a blank file, as you see that I have here. And I'm going to make the same physical configuration that you see in front of you in the software, under hardware configuration, rack 0. Alright, so what I've done is I've given it the IC695CHS007 slot rack. In slots 0 and 1, the first two slots is the IC695PSA040 power supply. And in slots 2 and 3, the third and fourth slots, is the IC695CPE310. Okay, so these two units use two slots apiece. Now, if you're following my arrow on the software here, if you see this plus sign next to the processor, if you click that, you'll expand to the Ethernet connection. Okay, if you double click on that, it's going to allow you to configure whatever IP address that would work for you. So what I would recommend is to use an IP address that you know isn't being used anywhere else on your network, and I'll show you how to test for that as well. So I've chosen such an address, and the next thing I want to do is download it. Alright, now in order to do that, I want to click the online button in order to get the processor to connect to the software. That's the lightning bolt icon in this upper left hand side, and once it is connected, I'm going to toggle online mode. I also notice that the COM2 port is blinking while I'm doing this. That means that the COM2 port is in fact working. You can both tell by the LED blinking and by the software connection. Alright. Another thing I want to draw your attention to, if you're following my arrow, is that the status that we're in right now is programmer mode, stop, disabled. Configuration and logic are not equal. Alright. So before we do the download, I'm going to go to Target, Online Commands, Clear. Now, what we want to do so that we don't get hung up in the middle of our download is we want to clear any controller or I/O fault tables. Because if there's anything that's faulty in there or not agreeing, it'll hang us up. I'm going to OK that. And I'm going to go to Download and Run. That's the Download Information and Run button in one. Now the first thing it's going to ask us, there'll be a window that pops open asking what exactly do we want to download to the processor. Now since this is not a program, it's a blank file, all we're going to do is hardware configuration and logic, the first two selections. Alright, we don't want to save anything to permanent flash memory. This is just a test to get the processor into run mode and retain it in run mode and check the COM ports. Okay. So it's going to go through a short download here. It's going to give us the download, the IP address that you've selected, that I've selected for this particular test. And then when that's all done, it's going to allow us to put the, or enable the outputs, or put it into run mode. Okay. And we're just about done. We're going to enable the outputs, yes, okay. Now, if you look down at the bottom, the status bar has changed. The programmer mode, run enabled, configuration equal, logic equal. Okay. So now we're going to test some of the other features now that it is in run mode. First thing is the run mode button itself. Currently, as you can see, outputs are enabled. It's in run mode and CPU is okay. So we're going to drop it down to disabling the outputs or the middle selection. So we've dropped the outputs. They're disabled now, but it's still in run mode, all right? And then we can drop the run mode right from the processor itself, okay? And back. Next thing I want to do is check the Ethernet connection. I have a local Ethernet plug here. It's connected to our network. And I'm going to plug that in. I usually wait about 30 seconds for it to catch up, and then I'm going to use that same address. If you're looking at my command prompt on the screen right now, it's the same address that I've chosen. I'm going to hit enter. Now immediately I have a response. It gives me the information bytes and the time it took. So what I want to do is, before I mention that, you want to make sure that when you do this, that you're not pinging another device that has that same address, this ending in 219 as you see here. So what I'm going to do is simply unplug my Ethernet connection, give it the same address, and ping it one more time. All right. So the purpose of that is obviously so when I ping it and I get a response back, I want to make sure that I'm not pinging another device that's been established that I don't know about or that I've forgotten about that has that same address, telling me that it's okay if it potentially isn't okay. All right. So we're sure this is okay. Next thing I want to test, I was describing before, a gender adapter. Okay, so this is a male 9-pin. And what I'm going to do is connect this to my comport 1. And then I'm going to look for activity on comport 1. As you can see, it's blinking. And eventually it gets caught up on Prophecy Machine Edition. Okay, so now we've tested the switch. We know that we're able to disable the outputs, disable the run mode, or put it back in run mode and enable the outputs. We know that COM port number 2, COM port number 1 are both working. The Ethernet is working. So the next thing I want to check is, if I feel that there's a problem with the processor, I'll go to Target, go to Diagnostics, and see if any faults come up. So now my info viewer table will now turn into a fault table viewer. And it's telling me that the transceiver fault is on the off the network. Well, that's just because I unplugged the Ethernet. So you can go down here to clear controller fault and empty that. Now, again, if you have a processor that may have more problems than that, then there could be more faults that are described here, more locations, and you can click on it and it gives you more description on the error code. And this can vary a little bit. Sometimes it's just as simple as you're unable to get it in a run mode. It may tell you that the configuration is not equal and you may find that there's a configuration mismatch. It might spell it out just that easily. But sometimes the faults can be a little bit more complicated and harder to understand, and they're written in more of like a code instead of an actual description. Okay, so again, if you guys feel that this is a processor that's giving you trouble, you're pretty sure that there's something wrong with it, CPE310 is something that we commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.